Murders in Chicago are on track to hit their highest level in nearly 20 years. There have been 441 homicides since the start of the year, up more than 40% over the same period last year. Now, the number of shootings has also spiked, 2,228 as of August 21st, which is up nearly 50%. Over last year, and home to close to 3 million people. Listen to this. Chicago has more homicides and shootings than any other city, according to FBI and police data, well ahead of both New York and Los Angeles, which both have much larger populations than Chicago. In fact, some people call the city Chirac, a name that draws an analogy between Chicago's South Side and Iraq's war zones. Joining me now is the former principal of a Chicago high school, Liz Dozier. She is now managing director of the social advocacy and action group called Chicago Beyond. Liz, we appreciate you joining us here on CNN today.
Thank you so much for having me, Amara.
You know, for international viewers, I mean, these are really astounding statistics. Help us understand, Liz, what is going on in Chicago that it's had more murders and shootings than the two largest cities in the U.S. combined, New York and Los Angeles?
I think that's what we're all trying to understand here, not only obviously in Chicago and nationally, but also internationally. And I think that it's easy to point fingers and to say it's this one thing here, or it's this thing over there, but really it's a complex history, and we didn't get to this point overnight. It's about disinvestments in communities. It's about education and the lack thereof in our communities, and this just propensity of us not providing solutions for people or wrapping people into the solutions that need to take place.
Well, part of the problem, I understand, is this gang problem, right? Especially in the South Side of Chicago. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Sure. I think one caveat I would want to bring to the table is that, like, people aren't born gang members, right? It's about a lack of hope and a lack of access, and the reason why people choose to join a gang as opposed to join an after-school club or to be invested in their education or in other activities, right? And so some of our children feel, and they are children, right, feel like there's no hope. When you think about what's happening here in Chicago, we have 45,000. Let me just emphasize that. 45,000 young people between the ages of 16 to 24 who are not working and who are not in school, right? So when we think about, you know, gang issues and other things that are really hurting our city, we have to look creatively and collaboratively amongst ourselves to really address that. If people have hope, if they have something to look forward to, they don't get involved in these type of activities. They're not born with this propensity towards violence.
And I think you were part of that solution. You were helping and giving students hope as a principal of a high school. And unfortunately, I think you were able to witness as well some of your students being lost to gun violence. Is that correct? And now you're part of this organization. Tell us about this organization and why you're putting your energy into this.
Yeah, so I was a principal for 6 years in one of the toughest neighborhoods here in Chicago. We were able to make change, and ultimately that inspired me to know that change is possible, growth is possible, and it helped me really understand the complexities of what our young people face. And so Chicago Beyond is really seeking to take a long-term, proactive look at how to support our young people for ultimate success. I would encourage people to go to our website, chicagobeyond.org, to learn more about our investments. But we're looking creatively for at that 45,000. So we're looking at, you know, young people who have been involved in detention centers. How do we create a pathway for them not only to get back in school, but ultimately to get a job? Because ultimately we can look at this as a social justice issue, but it's also an economic issue for our city as well. Not to mention the fact that these are people. Every time you hear of a shooting here in Chicago and someone's dying, that was someone's brother, someone's sister, like, our people matter.
Sure, absolutely. You know, and I have to mention, Chicago is often cited, Liz, as having, you know, some of the strictest gun laws in the country. And I think a lot of people, what they don't know is that, you know, a lot of the crimes that are committed in Chicago, those guns are coming from out of state. What do you think needs to be done from a legislative standpoint?
I think that we have to look at this again as a multifaceted issue. So yes, there are regulations and things that need to be put into place, but we also have to realize you could drop 100 or 1,000 guns in a healthy community and nothing would happen. When you drop 100 or 1,000 guns into an unhealthy community, then what happens? So we can look at the very surface, level response, but we have to go deeper to the root. And I think that's education. It's about mental health. It's about economic investment in communities. It's ultimately what Chicago Beyond is trying to do. Again, get at the root of what's happening here in our city and taking a long-term proactive approach to solutions.
Well, we really commend your activity in the community, and we wish you all the best. Liz Dozier, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.